Good morning. All right, Chevra.
Okay, Tov, Rabbi.
Okay, Or, here we go. Here we go. With the help of Hashem, we are learning Eruvin Daf Ayin Aleph. We are in the middle of the sugya of the machlokes between Rav Nachman and Divei Shmuel. The question was that we had on the bottom of Daf Ayin Amud Aleph, whether a Yoirish can be Mevatel Rishus. Case was is that there was a person, one of the members of the Chatzir, let's say the father, did not participate in the Eruv from before Shabbos. And as we continuously are learning, you know, the rules very beautifully articulated by Shmuel on Daf Samach Vav, that let's say the principal rule which will determine whether Bittul could or cannot be done is that it has to be done by a person that could have done the Eruv from before Shabbos. The father could have done the Eruv before Shabbos. So therefore, the father could do Bittul during Shabbos, Ladas Beisilo. The father passes away on Shabbos. Question is whether the Yoirish is able to do Bittul as well. Now, the Yoirish was unable to do Eruv because the Yoirish before Shabbos had no ownership here at all. That was the question. And Rav Nachman holds that indeed Yoirish could be Mevatel Rishus. I want to share just the following concept of Pi Chasidus, of this link that if you can do Eruv, then you can do Bittul. Generally, if you are unable to do Eruv, then you're unable to do Bittul. Eruv, which means to create a partnership, right, which is to create a relationship, to be some sort of equal, right? In Chassidus, we have very much the theme of a ben and an evet. There's an advantage from a ben over an evet. A ben has a metzias. An evet, the whole concept of an evet, which is the concept of bittul, means that you're not. And b'chalas, we have a klal that the more a person has an option to be, the more meaningful is their decision not to be. Bittul comes from someone that did not need to be bittul. That makes his bittul, her bittul, even more meaningful. This really fits into this whole topic. We had various challenges on Rav Nachman, and we're going to start today on Daf Ayin Aleph, Amud Aleph, 70 lines from the top of the Amud. We're going to give one response which will address two of the challenges that we have against Rav Nachman by explaining it from a whole different way, unlike we explained it in last year. We're going to start on Daf Ayin Aleph, a Mishnah. Now, Chevra, the Mishnah will begin the following. Number one, Eruv Chatzeros and Shittut Mavois is conceptually the same concept. Just like you have many people owning individual homes, sharing their rights in the Chatzit, similarly, many Chatzeros who have their own rights, only they have their rights in their own Chatzit, but they share rights in the Mavui. So just like you have to make an Eruv Chatzeros to be allowed to carry from your house into the Chatzer, same thing, various Chatzeros that would like to share the Mavui, they have to do Shituf Mavois. It's really the same thing. We use another word just to clarify which one is referring to the Mavui. We call that a Shituf. Which one is referring to the Chatzer, calling that an Eruv. However, there are differences. And one difference will be that for Eruv Chatzeros, you need to use bread or matzah. For Shituf Mavois, you need not use pas. You could use wine, you could use other beverages, and you could use other foods. Now, the case that we're going to deal with is phenomenal. Let's say that there are three people, just to simplify it, that have rights in the Mavui. Reuven, Shimon, and Levi. They have to make a shituf mavois. What were to happen if, putting aside the need of carrying from the chatzar into the mavi, putting that aside, Reuven and Shimon are partners, and they actually own wine in partnership. Reuven and Shimon. Reuven and Levi have another partnership. In other words, through Reuven, everyone is partners. Not that they made a specific partnership for carrying in the mavui. More than that, not that they are all of them are shutvim. But again, Reuven is a shutv with Shimon, and Reuven is a shutv with Levi. So there is a whole approach, and there's a shita, Tana, the Mishnah, that holds that in certain circumstances, that in itself is like a shituf mavois, and no specific shituf mavois needs to be done to be able to carry from the chatzeros into the mavui. It's phenomenal. Other tanaim, as we'll learn, will disagree with that. And we're going to learn the difference between their partnership is with wine. Wine, theoretically, you can mix all the wines together. What were to happen if Reuven and Shimon are partners in wine? Reuven and Levi, ooh, they're partners in oil. Wine and oil doesn't mix. Will that affect that partnership to take the place and to be effective like a shituf mavois or not? We're going to have on that in the Mishnah, we're going to have two shitas. And daf ayin aleph amud beis, we're going to bring down a third tana that's quoted in a braisa, the shita of Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi, and we're going to have various ways of understanding his shita, much to understand what that braisa means. And finally, on the ayin aleph amud beis, we're going to quote the following machlekes tanoim, whether soimchin or ein soimchin al shitu b'makum eruv. What does that mean? We're going to learn the sugya the way Rashi learns it. When we speak about Eruvi Chatzeros, really there are two applications for Eruvi Chatzeros. There's the classical application, which is you have one chatzer, you have many homes, at least two, that open up into the chatzer. All of the balabatim have rights in the chatzer, and you have to make an Eruv Chatzeros for everyone to be considered partners in all of their properties, in the house and in the chatzer. That's the classical, basic Eruvi Chatzeros. We're going to be focusing on the secondary Eruvi Chatzeros. And that is, whenever you have two adjacent chatzeros, chatzer aleph, chatzer beis, each chatzer made their own eruv. There is an opening, there is a door, there is a window that allows you to go between chatzer aleph and chatzer beis. If both of these neighbors want, they could make an eruv chatzeros, which will not only allow them to carry from their own house into their own chatzer, but that would also allow them to carry from their house into their chatzer into the neighboring chatzer. That Eruv Chatzeros. Now think about a scenario where you have Chatzeros that are adjacent to each other. These Chatzeros also share the same Mavui. Which means, guys, halt kop over here, that the people that live in a Chatzer, Aleph, they can go out from their Chatzer into the Mavui. They also have an option of going out from their Chatzer into an adjacent Chatzer without using the Mavui. What's going to happen if the people in such a setting, they make a shituf mava'is, all of the chatzeres that open up to the same mavi made a shituf b'mavui, using wine, does that allow them automatically to go direct from one chatzer to the other? There's a logic to say that, yeah. Because basically, if everyone that lives here is becoming partners, so then they become partners, you can argue, in everything, or not. That's called soimchin al hashituf. And it should also help you for the Eruv of adjacent Chatzeros, or Ein Soimchin al Shituf b'makom Eruv. We're going to learn the nuances, exactly what did they use to make a Shituf Mavois. Now, don't forget, like we mentioned, Shituf Mavois could be done with wine. Eruv Chatzeros needs to be done with bread. Everyone agrees with that. So we're going to go into details. Maybe you can be Soimach on a Shituf. It should also do that adjacent chatzeros as long as the shituf was done with bread, because bread could have been done lechatchila to be ma'ar of the chatzeros. What happens if the shituf mavois was done with wine? We're going to learn that there is a shita that holds it's also going to be effective as a eruv chatzeros. Lechatchila, you don't use wine for eruv chatzeros, but since wine is good, allows you to be meshatev the mavoi, it affects a shituf mavois. Once you made a shituf mavois and everyone is already a partner, it automatically, by default, will also extend over to the eruv chatzeros. This will more or less be today's daf. Let's start the daf ayin aleph amud aleph. We are 17 lines, we're almost in the middle of the amud, from the top of the amud. Again, we have the Shita of Rav Nachman, not Tana Devei Shmuel. But Rav Nachman holds that Yoyrish is Mevatel. I, the Yoyrish, was unable to be Ma'arev before Shabbos, so we said that Yoyrish Kare Da Avua. No, the Yoyrish was able to be Ma'arev. Not him, his father was. Now, we had various braises that implied that in the case either of a Yoyrish, or as we spoke out to Toisvus, whenever there's a Yid that's going to be Machzik in the Nechasim of a Geir who passed away without having halachic heirs, he is like a Yoyrish. It's mashma from two braises, both in the case of a Yoyrish and in the case of a Machzik Benichsi Hager, that they cannot be Mevatel. So for that, Rabbi Yechanan Amar, yes, you're right. You're right. The two braises that seem to imply that a Yoyrish cannot be Mevatel, correct? Not the way we answered before the Asers, but they could be Mevatel. But that follows Masniyasa in Lashon Rabim, that follows Beishamai, that we just had before. The Machlekes we had on the Samach Tes on the days in the Mishnah. When exactly can Bittel be done? Right? We obviously Paskin like Beisilo. But Beishamai held that Bittel can only be done from before Shabbos. So it's perfect. Both of these cases was a case where either the Yoyrish or the Yid that was Machzik did not own it before Shabbos. So obviously, if you only come into ownership during Shabbos, you can't do anything because Bittel, the Beishamai, cannot be done on Shabbos. That the two braises follows Beishamai, the Omri, that hold Ein Bittel Rishus B'Shabbos. As we just learned, Samach Tes Amud Beis, the aim is Ein Noisnin Rishus. Now I'm going to focus on the words Noisnin. Yeah, we said correctly. Noisnin means Mevatel. But hold on. We keep on saying in English, Mevatel means to relinquish. Noisnin means to give. It's hugely different. So you now we'll see in the next few lines, we'll understand better why sometimes the Tanoim use the words Noisnin, Rishus, particularly our Mishnah, Samach Tes Amud Beis, that begins with Beishamai. And we'll speak this out in a moment. So anyways, Noisnin means Mevatel. Beishamai says, from when can you give Rishus? Only Mibo Adyoy. So holds Beishamai. It's Beisil that hold Misha Techshach. Now it's Gevaldik. So that already answered. Yeah, you have braises that imply that a Yoyrish cannot be Mevatel. Of course, if you follow the Shita of Beishamai, then how can a Yoyrish be Mevatel on Shabbos, even if the father would have been alive? Yoyrish kana davure. Okay, good. The father cannot be Mevatel on Shabbos, neither can the Yoyrish. Now, we're going to try to analyze what is the underlying argument between Beishamai and Beisilil. So Amar Ulam, my comment to Beis Hillel, and the reason why we're asking first Beis Hillel, not only because we paskin like him, because there is a rule that we don't make kinyanim on Shabbos. I know it's only us. Well, really, there's a Rashi in Beyam that brings both opinions. I know we quoted Shema Yichtoiv, you might write a contract. That's a Gzeirim Edirabanan. But there's also from the Pasuk in Yeshayim, Mimetzoi Cheftzecha, that's called Divrei Kabbalah, that is a notch more chamur than Divrei Seifrim. It's not a Doiraisa. That's another reason why you can't do Kinyanim. It's considered part of doing your mundane activities. Be that as it may, we don't make Kinyanim on Shabbos. So why would we Bittel work? Because Nasika Oimer, Kalachet Zol Yafes. This is huge. Kalachet Zol Yafes, the whole sugya of Shlichus and Kedushin, right? The rule is that Truma need not be separated by the owner of the produce, but it must be done on his behalf. So that's one of the sources that I can send you to be mafresh my trumas umaisres. Now what happens if you on your own decided to do me a favor and to separate all of the trumas umaisres for me? So the question is, how did I react, the Balabas, when he found out about it? If the Balabas tells the person, you took off Trumas, you know, you could have gone to even better. You should have separated even my better to give it to the Kohen. Now, maybe the person meant to make that statement cynically. We have that concept in Halacha. So you have to check. If the owner had nothing better, then we know he meant, like, why didn't you take it even from the better? That was his way of saying, who are you to take from me? But if the person taka has yafois, then we interpret that he didn't mean to make a cynical statement. The moment he's megaladas, that he agreed for those trumos umaisres to be separated, so the halacha is it's effective. Now, why is it effective? Well, I was megaladas now. You took off my trumos umaisres without me sending you as my shliach. So the pshat is, by klache etzel yafois, that now that we discover that the Baal HaBos was content with the fact that they were separated, it's as if he asked them to do it before he did it. That's the concept in Allah. It's called V'amrinan keman. Rashi brings the words that we have in Bava Metziah. V'amrinan keman v'shaviyei shliach meikarim. So you know what? By Bito, wow, says Ula and Beisilo, if a person is mevatel reshus on Shabbos, you know what we say? It's as if he was mevatel reshus from before Shabbos. Gavaldike concepts. No, it's really a kinyan cannot be done on Shabbos. So how can you do bittul on Shabbos? Reading inside the Rashi, Hachinami kiven de bottle hashta gale date de meikara b'shereyusa nichole ela sheshachach v'lo yedev. It's not like he's doing something now. It's as if he did it before. That's Ula's approach. So Amalei Abaye, Omer Abaye, really Abaye is challenging Ula. Can't be. Because we had a case on Daf Samach Zayin. What happens if you have an Achatzar Yidin, more than one, two or more, and a Goy, and nothing was done before Shabbos, not Tzchirus, not Eruv. Then Neis Nachri B'Shabbos. So Abaye holds, now that there's no issue with Tzchirus, Abaye says, on Shabbos you can do Bittul. Hold on. If Bittul is almost like retroactive, it's as if the bittul was done before Shabbos, then it won't explain why, if Meis Nachri B'Shabbos, bittul can be done on Shabbos. Because to say it's as if it was done before Shabbos the Nachri was alive. When the Nachri was alive, just bittul is not enough. Just like just Eduf is not enough. There's a Nachri there. Schirus is needed. So by the fact that even in a case where before Shabbos, bittul would not have been effective, yet bittul could be done on Shabbos, holds Abaye, that it's not some sort of retroactive bittul. My klach etzel yafis ikah. My klach etzel yafis, everyone understands that it goes some sort of command the shavi shliach meikar. It's a retroactive appointment of shlichas, but that's not the way bittul works. Elo explains Abaye. Now we understand why the Braisa, like the Tanoim, I'm sorry, the Mishnah and the Braisa, sometimes uses the words nois nin neshus. The machloikas is exactly what is bittul. Beishamai holds that the concept of bittul reshus is not relinquishment. I know we keep on saying that because then we follow Beisilo. Bittul means giving. Bittul means mikna reshusi. Mikna means to transfer, to give over, noisnin. And that exactly cannot be done on Shabbos. That's why Beishamai says it can only be done before Shabbos. Or mikna reshusi b'Shabbos, asur. We don't make kinyan. However, Beisilo understands that relinquishment doesn't mean giving. It only means removing oneself. Removing oneself is not a transfer. Beisilo sabri is only istaluke reshusa ba'almohu. I'm only removing myself. And istaluke reshusa b'Shabbos indeed is something that is permitted. L'mashul, I'll give you two examples. Hefker, can a person be mafker on Shabbos? The answer is yes, because hefker doesn't mean that I'm giving it to you. Hefker means I'm no longer the owner. Second area in halacha that's discussed is called mechila. If I owe you something, can you be moichel me? The answer is yes, you can do mechila on Shabbos. Why? Because mechila means you're not giving it to me, you're removing yourself from your claim over it. You're removing yourself. It's amazing. But if it would have been a transfer, transfer cannot be done on Shabbos.
Rabbi, what about a schirus on Shabbos from the guy?
What about schirus on Shabbos, which we had before? That's very good. Another question, speaker. What about, so we're going to go to schirus. By schirus, the Gemara said, schirus is called schirus ru'ua. It's not a real schirus. Since it's not a real schirus, that's why, I mean, we had a question whether you can do schirus on Shabbos or not. That's why not that problematic. The other issue of Shabbos, which is really halacha lemaisa, is a gift. That's a big issue. It's very common in the place where there's an eruv that you invite me to your house. I bring you a bottle of wine. Give you an example. People give matanas on Shabbos. That's a big problem. Just to be aware of that. Ideally, don't do that. Just not to get into this whole machloikas. many people, they do an act of schiyah. That means that if I'm going to your house, Tzvika, but I don't see you before Shabbos, I'll go over to my son and I'll ask him to pick up the wine on your behalf, Lamashal. I really want to. So you already own it. So you already own it, then I bring it over to you. Or I can be committing many people that are very stingy. When I come and I give you a bottle, I don't really give it to you. I share it with you. I share it with you on your table. That's another way of viewing the gift. All right. All right. Danny, you good? Okay.
So wait, can you just apply this case of the guy passing away on Shabbos to Beisilel Beishamai?
Oh, of course. In other words, Beisilel holds that since I'm not giving, I'm only removing yourself could be done on Shabbos. Doesn't go back retroactive. So Abaye subscribes that if now there's an opportunity that only with Bittul you'll resolve the issue of carrying it, you can do Bittul on Shabbos. Okay. Now, Chevrat Nochamo. This is the whole Dafna. Few klolim. Eruv and Shituv is conceptually the same, but there are technical differences. Be'ikir, what's Negev for today is, Eruv Chatzeres has to be done with everyone participating with bread. Shituv Mavois is a lot more liberal. You don't need bread. You can use anything. You can use bread. You can use wine. You can use other foodstuffs. We learned before you can use vinegar. As long as it is enough for two meals, not for every individual, for everyone. Just remember that. Number two. The concept is you're making a incorporation. You're merging everyone together. The case in the Mishnah is we're focusing now on Mavui, Shituv Mavois, again, just to simplify it. I know it's really each Chatzar joining with their fellow Chatzar. I'm just going to give names to each Reuven, Shimon, and Levi. What happens if Reuven and Shimon were or are already partners? They made a partnership with food, with wine. They both own a barrel of wine together. And by the way, the barrel of wine is already placed in one of the chatzeres. The shituv mavois is placed in one of the chatzeres, just like a ruvi chatzeres is placed in one of the houses. There's already a barrel of wine owned in partnership. Now, if everyone would be partners in it, even though they didn't join to make the shituv mavois, they are pashut partners. That for sure would be good enough already for the shituv mavois. That's chiddush number one. You don't have to do a dafka for a Shabbos. They're partners, so they're already incorporated. Question is, everyone is partners, but not together. There's one that links everyone. So Reuven is a partner with Shimon. Reuven is a partner with Levi. Two different partnerships. Says the Mishnah, Baal Habayis, let's call him Reuven. Baal Habayis really means one chassid. Baal Habayis, Shehayu Shutav. He's already a Shutav with his neighbors. With all the neighbors, everyone that's using the Mavui are partners, but not all together. There's one that's linking everyone. L'mashal, L'zebiyayin or L'zebiyayin. Again, Reuven and Shimon, Reuven and Levi. So if he is, Reuven is a partner with Shimon, owning wine together. He's also a partner with Levi, owning wine together. And as, according to the first approach in the Gemara Rav, these wines are together in the same keli. Ah, that's a whole new layer that the Mishnah doesn't say. So all of the wine is together in the same keli. In that keli, everyone is partners. Not everyone with everyone, but there is a link between everyone. Says the Mishnah, says the Tanakhama, Eino Tzricha La'arav. No new Eruv, meaning Shituv, has to be done. Double Chiddush, guys. Number one, you don't have to make a partnership for carrying in the Mavui on this Shabbos. You don't need to do that. You have to be partners. They make partnerships, nothing to do with Mavui. Doesn't matter. They are partners. Chiddush number two, that's even a bigger chiddush, they're not all partners together. But since Reuven links both of them, Aleph, number two, what they own is, according to the way Rashi says, the way the first approach in the Gemara, it's in one keli. So that's a bona fide shituv mavois. However, says the Tanakhama, if Lezebayayin but Ulezebashemen, Reuven and Shimon own wine together. Reuven and Levi own oil together. Oil doesn't mix with anything. So then, Srichem La'arev, then a new sheet of Mavais has to be made. These partnerships do not combine. Now, again, the first approach will be because wine and oil are kept in two different kalim. Okay, more details in the Gemara. However, Reb Shimon says, that's this in this Mishnah, there's two opinions. On Amud Beis, we're going to learn a third opinion of Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi. But here in our Mishnah, Rabbi Shimon says, Echad Zeh. Echad Zeh is more lenient. Einam tzricham lo'arev. Now let's understand the Shita, the Tanakama. Why does Rabbi Shimon disagree? Why is he more lenient? Approach number one. Says the Gemara Amarav. I want you to know that when the Tanakama says that Lezebi Yain or Lezebi Yain, Ein tzricham lo'arev, that's only Ube Keli Yechad. It's only, it's not about wine. It's about that it's in one Keli. Now, Rashi reminds us that on Daf Memtes Amad Aleph, we clearly learn Shitas Beis Hillel, that the Shituf does not need to be in one Keli. Says Rashi, well, hold on. The case of Daf Memtes is that everyone is joining together in a partnership, in an incorporation for the Shituf Mavois. Everyone begins to put their food in one Keli. If that Keli gets full, Va'ayater, that was the words we had on Daf Memtes, and now there's even more food, now you can use a separate Keli. That's where Beis Hillel says you can use a separate Keli. Over here, no one b'chlal joined for a Shituf Mavois. They made prior partnerships. Since they made prior partnerships, if each partnership was always segregated, separated, it doesn't combine. It only combines because it's in one Keli. So explains Rashi. And Omar Rava backing up Rav, Taikanami, our Mishnah, actually has a diuk that will back that up from the Sefer, from the second case. What does it say, the Tanakam? That Lezebi Yain, Lezebi Shem, and Tzrichim.
Rabbi.
Yes.
Just a technical point. Because this partnership is not, it wasn't entered into specifically for the purpose of Shitav Mavois, right?
Correct.
Does the wine still have to be present in the Mavoi, or they could just be in the guy's house because he's the, like, the central partner?
That's that. We're going to get to all of these pratim later. Exactly where does the food have to be? What happens if the food was consumed on Shabbos? It's going to follow all of the rules of a Shitav. Actually, the big question here on the Ayin Aleph amongst the Rishonim is, do these partners have to at least verbalize that the wine that we already have as prior partners, that should be the Makim HaShituf? That's the big question over here. Or somebody should say they don't even have to say that. They are already considered all incorporated. But Danny, your questions is not our sugya. But that's good questions. We're going to learn all these dinim later. Okay. Now.
Meaning is this partnership just like me and you are whatever, where we own real estate together. We're partners.
Mamish. Mom,
does that work for this?
No, it has to be food, and we're going to learn more details on the Ayin Aleph Amud Beis. Even us having a joint bank account is not good enough. It has to be food. And even if our money bought food, we'll get to that later. If we incorporated, not by me giving wine and you giving wine, if I gave money and you gave money, that might be problematic, even though later the money then brought wine. It's a question on today's stuff. Let's go back. So now, Amar Rava Daikinama, because since it says in the second case in the Tanakhama that Lezebi Yain, Lezebi Shemen, and then Tzricham Lo'arev, wine. What's the difference? Wine oil. So, E Amar Abdishlema Reisha B'Keli Yechad, and V'Seifa B'Shnei Kelim. Wine and oil is just an example. Wine and oil are not put together. But really, even the wine and wine, if it's not in the same Keli, it's not Ma'arev. Then it works. But Eli E Amar Abdishlema B'Shnei Kelim, if even wine and wine aren't two different Kelim, and Seifas Mishnei Kalim, so Mali Yain V'Yain, Mali Yain V'Shemen. So therefore, he backs up Rav. So that's, we're going to call that now Shitas Rava, because Abai and Rav are contemporaries, and Abai disagrees. Amalei Abai, there's no proof, and I'll learn the whole Mishnah different. I'll tell you what. The Mishnah is even referring to these two partnerships. Wines are in two different Kalim. Yet, the Tanakama holds Yain V'Yain is in the place of a mother. You know why? Because it's ro'ui lo'arev. The concept in Allah, it's fit. It's fit to be mixed. Yain v'yayin ro'ui lo'arev. It's fit to be combined. Yain v'shemen ein ro'ui lo'arev. Therefore, Abaye will hold, we'll have to remember this, that our Mishnah is even speaking about two kalim. Nevertheless, since yain and yain ro'ui lo'arev, it combines halachically for the shituf mavois, yain and shemen don't combine halachically, and by the way, lav dafka, we'll see that that's another machloek, because that will explain Rav Shimon, and therefore, according to the Tanakama, tzrichim la'arif. Now, referring to Rav Shimon, Rav Shimon, you never need to make an eruv. In other words, afilu lezebe yayin or lezebe shemen, how would you explain that? And this question is particular on Abaya. I mean, it's two different partnerships. It's items that are uncombinable. how does it make everyone incorporate? Amar Abam, Hachamayaskinon, indeed. No, the Rav Shimon is not referring to the simple case of the Tanakhama. The Rav Shimon is referring to one specific case. And if somebody can put up a picture, it's good. If not, it's also good. I'll explain it, God willing. Case here, guys, this is very similar, but not the same. Remember Naf Memhei Amad Aleph in the bottom, Memhei Amad Beis on top, the Mishnah, when you had three Chatzeirois, no Mavi, three Chatzeirois, each Mavi opened up to the Rishus HaRabim, but also each Mavi opened up to each other. And there we learned the case was that the middle chatzer made an eruv chatzedus with the one on the right. The middle one made an eruv chatzedus with the one on the left. The two outer ones did not combine. So Taka, the two outer ones, you can't take something from the outer on one side through the middle and bring it to the other side. You can't do that. But Rav Shimon used that as an example for the other case we had in the Mishnah of three people, that there are four amas overlap. The middle guys for Amos overlaps with the outside ones. The outside ones don't touch each, they don't overlap each other. Okay, and I say maybe I'll put up a picture for this. But anyways, this is the case over here. Here, guys, yeah, if you see a picture, there are two mavois. Now, the one in the middle and the one on the right, Gavaldik, look in the top picture that's on the screen. The bottom picture is the case in the Mishnah. It's not the same. The top picture is what we are referring to. Now, can you take something from a house from one side, go through the mavui on the right, go inside the middle chutz and go into the mavui of the left? For that, you have to make a shituf mavois with everyone together. The case of the Mishnah, Lirab Shimon, is when the guy in the middle, the people in the middle, they had a prior partnership with wine with the people on the right. The Bnei Achatzin in the middle had a prior partnership with the people on the left with oil. And when Abshimon says they don't have to make a shituf, he doesn't mean that you can carry from the outside through the middle to the other mavui. No. All it means is that the ones who live in the middle, they can both carry in the mavui to their right and they can carry in the mavui to their left because they have their own prior partnership with each side. But not that it combines that the outer Bnei HaChatzin can use both Mavois, that not, inside. And Abshim, and this will follow similar to here on the screen to the picture we have on the bottom, which is the case on Daf Memhei Amud Beis. The time you learned in that Mishnah, Amar Abshim and Lama, Hadavar Deimam, we're speaking about three people who only have four Amas to walk from Eruv Tchumen. All they have is four Amas. And the middle ones overlaps with the outer ones. And that if he, the middle one, is mutaras imam, but the hein, the outer ones are only mutaras imam, but the shtayim achitzoynes asuras zomzu. And Abshimon's chiddush is that we're not afraid that an article that's coming from the chatzon on one side will end up in the chatzon on the opposite side. We're not afraid of that. So same thing over here, Rav Shimon's leniency of allowing to use the shutfas of Yain and of Shemen is not to combine everyone together. Amalei Abaye, to Rabba's understanding. In Rav Shimon, how can you compare our Mishnah, Daf Ayin Aleph, to over there, Daf Mem Hamid Beis? Over there, by the Gemara, three lines from the bottom, Ketani, Shtayim, Hachitzoni, Yisas. Rav Shimon says those words. Over here, it's not mashma on the Mishnah, because here the words that Rav Shimon used are Ein Tzrichim La'arif Klal, not mashma that he's only allowing the ones in the middle to use both mavois because they have a partnership b'yayin and with the other one b'shemen. So the Gemara says that doesn't refute the Rabba's understanding, because I can argue that what does it mean in our Mishnah, the words of Rav Shimon, Ein Tzrichim La'arif, last line, it means that Shechinim Ba'adim Alabayis, that the outer ones with the inner ones don't have to make a new shituf mavois. They already have a partnership, even though the partnership was not made for shituf. That's the chiddush number one of the Mishnah. But Abu Shechinim, Bahadi Abdadi, Shechinim means the two outer ones, exactly that. Tzrichim lo'ar. Okay, that's approach number one in understanding the shita of Rav Shimon. Chavra daf ayin aleph amid beis. Now we're going to learn another understanding, the shitas Rav Shimon, which will take into account, right, the challenge that Abaya had No, Rav Shimon is referring to the same case of the Tanna Kamma. And when Rav Shimon says Ein Sarach La'ar of Klal, he means that everyone can use the Mavri. Question is, what's the underlying argument? This is a Gavaldik. A Mishnah got in Tful Yoyim. Now, guys, we had this not that long ago. What's the Mishnah in Tful Yoyim? Guys, a Tful Yoyim is someone who was Tamei, who already went to the mikvah, but until it becomes dark, until Tzeis HaKichavim, there's a vestige of Tumah, not strong enough to be Metama Chulin, not even strong enough to be Metama Maisa Sheni, right? The first Mishnah Brachas, but strong enough that it's on the level of a Sheni, and that person, if that person touches Tumah, makes the Tumah a Shlishi. Remember another detail. Sometimes the Tana uses the words Tumah. Sometimes the Tana uses the words Puzzle. So the Klal by Tumah is, whenever something is Tumah enough, that it not only is it Tumah, but it could impart Tumah, we use the words Tumah. When something is at the end of the line, we say puzzle, invalidated. But we never use the words tameh because it can't pass it on, which is exactly the name of a tful yoyim. A tful yoyim can puzzle truma because tful yoyim is a sheni, right? If there's halachic contact with truma, the truma becomes a shlishi. That's it. Truma that touches other truma, shlishi cannot make a revi by truma. So if a tful yoyim touches truma, he puzzles it. What happens if you have wine and oil in one keli? The oil floats to the top. What happens if the tful yoyim touches the oil? The oil for sure becomes pusel, right? It becomes a shlishi. What's the status of the wine? Do we view it as one entity? And therefore, just like the oil became a shlishi, automatically so did the wine. They're in one keli. Just like wine, the tful yoyim that touches the wine on the top, he doesn't have to stick his finger all the way down. All the wine in the keli becomes a shlishi. It's one unit. Or do we say, no, wine and oil are two entities. That is a machlokes tanoim. And that's going to be the underlying machlokes over here. And by the way, we're going to remember Abaya on Amud Aleph. Abaya argues with Rava. Abaya says that our Mishnah can be in two kelim. It's about whether ro'ui la'adav or not. So here, let's go inside. The machlekes in tful yoyim, in the Mishnah is tful yoyim. Ditnan, shemen, shutzof, al gaba yayim, and oil is floating on wine, and the tful yoyim touches the top, shemen, so the Tana Kama hold, the Chachamim hold, the pasal, ela, shemen bulvad, farvos, because wine and oil halachically remain two entities, even if they are in the same keli, which is the sheet of our Tana Kama. So these two partnerships are completely separated. However, Rabbi Yechinen ben Uri, which will be the shita here of Rabbi Shimon, holds no, that since Shneim are halachically called Chiburim Zelozeh, they are considered connected, not only physically, but halachically, and therefore, the Tful Yoyim that touches the top, everything in that keli, even the wine underneath it, becomes puzzle as well. So therefore, Rabbanan Kerabbanan, and Rabbi Shimon, Rabbi Yechinen ben Uri, even following Abaya, since he holds that wine and oil, had they been put in the same keli, like ro'ui la'arev, they're fit to be combined halachically. So therefore, even b'shnei kelim, okay. We don't need that picture that much yet, but okay, leave it up. It's already up over there. Very good. Now, in our Mishnah, we have these two opinions. The Tana Kama was lenient to a point. Yain, yain. Rav Shimon was mamish lenient, especially the way Rav Yosef explains it. Yain and Shemin. Again, Reuven, Shimon, and Levi, they don't have a common partnership, but Reuven and Shimon and Reuven and Levi, we put it all together. Now, Tanya, we have a third shita, that Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi Oimer, Echodzeh, whether Reuven and Shimon and Reuven and Levi have prior their own wine partnerships, or Reuven and Shimon and Reuven and Levi have prior one wine and one oil, always, always, this is more chamor than the Tana Kama and Mishnah. Always tzrichim la'arev. Now, by the way, as we'll see in a few lines, lav dafka, we said correct pshat here in the Braisa. But we are beginning with the premise that the case of Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi is exactly the case of the Mishnah. And here we have a third sheet. Now, presuming that that's so, so the question will be, why mela wine and oil, as we just explained, one approach, another approach, lav dafka, it's ro'i la'arev. But afilu lezeh b'yayin or lezeh b'yayin, why would Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi not agree that it's combinable? So here, Amar Rabba, I mentioned this a bit back. Okay. Zeb Baba Liginoi Vishafach, Zeb Baba Liginoi Vishafach, Kula Amole Pligadahavi Eruv. If when Reuven and Shimon became partners, not for Shabbos, when they became partners, how do you become partners? One way of becoming partners is if our partnership is in wine, I bring physically my wine and you brought your wine and we put it together. Which is exactly how you were to make a shituv mavois. How do you make a shituv mavois? Giving money, we learned before, money is never a way not to do a shituv mavois, not to do an erev chatzedus, for whatever reasons the Gemara said, we don't use money. If they began their partnership, not l'shem shituv, but they began their shutvus by each one giving wine, Reuven gave wine and Shimon gave wine in one barrel. Reuven gave wine and Levi gave wine in another barrel, or according to Rav, now it's all in one keli. Then the, even Ablozer ben Tadoi would be minded that it does work. Case of Ablozer ben Tadoi is ki pligi ki goin shalachu chavir shal yayin b'shutvus, that their partnership in the beginning, Reuven and Shimon's partnership milechatchila, wasn't that each one gave wine. Each one gave money. And they put it in a joint account. Now that account bought wine. This has nothing to do, according to this understanding, has nothing to do whether we combine Reuven and Shimon's and Reuven and Levi's partnership. It has nothing to do with that. It has to do with, do we accept this type, even if it would have been just two people, two chatzeres, and they, prior to making a shituv mavois, they became partners. Prior. So you would say, ah, l'kula alma, the Mishnah says it works. Hold on, not so simple. If they became partners by each one giving wine, yes, that's the premise, that's the chiddush number one of the Mishnah. But if they became prior partners by each one giving money, and now the money brought wine before Shabbos. So how do we view that? And this is similar to Breda. It's not the normal Breda. It's similar to the concept of Breda. When the money buys wine, do we say it is as if each one brought the wine? I brought the money, yeah, but the money bought the wine. Or do we say no, that if we become incorporated through money, now that this money buys the wine never is coming from Reuven and Shimon. The wine, lechatchila, belongs to the corporation. That's not the way you do a shituv. So the din number one of the Mishnah, that even if they had a prior partnership, now that also will function as the shituv mavois. On that, Rabbi Lazar ben Tadoi says, only if they became partners by giving food. But if they became partners by giving money, even though the money bought wine before Shabbos, doesn't help. So the echad zeh, it has nothing to do with combining two different partnerships. It's as if he's saying, regardless the case of the Mishnah, wine and oil, to take all that out. In a scenario where the partners, each individual partner, didn't begin with food or with wine, it doesn't work. Let me read it inside.
Now, so, Rabbi, if there's 10 people living in a mavoi, every single one has to give a shtickel wine. Otherwise, that you can't make a shittif that way?
Exactly. We had this before. Or Zachama Adam. I can take my wine. Before I make the shittif, I can bequeath it. I can gift it to each member. So everyone owned the wine, and then I make the shittif, which is what we do today in Eruv. When I have Yiddish neighbors, I'll take a box of matzah and I'll make a kinyan zachem to everyone. But what am I makne to them? Not money. Already the bread. Their partnership has to be by participation of food and not of money. Now, Blaz ben Tadoi saw that this is such a great machloikis. Like, how do you view partnerships? Which is normally, at least many partnerships today begins, every partner gives money. Now you have a pool of money. Now the money does something. Breda would mean, again, not the classical Breda. Breda means the concept of retroactive, that if we went ahead and we bought real estate, it's as if every partner, lechatchila, bought that part of the house. I bought the bedroom, you bought the living room. Or, no, everyone gave a chelik in the money, but the money doesn't belong to any individual. The money belongs to the group, to the collective. In Portuguese, it's called to the pessoa jurídica. You know, there's a personal person and then there's an incorporated person. It belongs to the tzibur. It belongs to the corporation. It's a whole different concept. Amazing. Wow.
Legal person. Huh? The term in English is legal person.
The legal person, the Valdik. So the legal person is not good for an Eruv. Bereda means, even though it was bought by the legal person, but it's ki'ilu retroactive. What the legal person is comprised of, What's the contrast? Individual people, private people. So it's as if it was worked by the private people. Rabbi Elazar doesn't subscribe to that. Ein b'reira. Rabbi Anan hold the eish b'reira. Again, the little Tosfos here writes, the second Tosfos. Ein zeke ein b'reiros b'chol de b'chol duchta. This is not the normal application of b'reira, but it's similar to the concept of taking it a step back. Okay. Now we have a third approach. Ah, azoy gishmak. We have a third approach. And that is that the b'raisa of Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi is not b'chlal referring to the case of the Mishnah. What is it referring to? So let's repeat. This is important. We're learning Gemara Rashi. There are ways of learning this Gemara in completely different. Rashi learns like this. I know whenever we say an Eruv Chatzeres, people think about the classical Eruv Chatzeres. We're not referring to houses in a chatzer. That's not what we're talking about. We are talking about that if you have, just let's make two adjacent chatzeres that has a halachically large enough opening between them, aside of each chatzer making their own Eruv Chatzeres, which they have to do, if they want, they can make an Eruv Chatzeres to join these two chatzeres. In a case where there is such a mitzias, not only could they go directly from chatzer aleph to chatzer beis, aside of that, every chatzer opens up to a mavi. Now, if they only made a shituv muvois, so they made each one made their own native chatzeres, they made a proper shituv muvois, not like in the Mishnah, they made a proper shituv muvois. Now, I want to know whether we say that since they made a shituv, will that automatically also allow them to carry directly from one chatzer to the other? Does a shituv muvois automatically also take the place of the Eruv Chatzeres, which joins these two Chatzeres or not? And that is a machlokes tanoim, and it is exactly this that Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi is referring to. Rabbi Yosef Amar, Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi, and the Rabbanon, they're speaking about the question when Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi says the words, Tzrichim la'arev. Tzrichim la'arev doesn't mean that they have to make a sheet of mavois. No, as far as the case of do they have to make a sheet of mavois, I'll argue that he holds, especially Lezeh B'yayin or Lezeh B'yayin, L'kula Al in our Mishnah that works. He's speaking about a scenario where the Shituv Mavois worked. There's a new question. Do they now, but they didn't make an Eruv Chatzeres to go from one Chatzer to the other. On that, now it's Benduyek. Now Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi says, not Tzricham L'Shatev. Here it's Medayek. There's even where the Shituv works, still you have to make an Eruv Chatzeres. Because this is the machlokes whether soimchen al shituv b'makom eruv or not komifligi. The mar sabar, which is Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi, right, that ain't soimchen. Gevaldik. Umar sabar, that means the ones who argue with Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi, they say whenever there's a shituv, however it came about, even if the shituv came about the way it is in our sugya, they never even made a shituv muvois, they were partners prior. Whenever halacha says that you got yourself a good shituv muvois, you're good to go. Automatically, you have an Eruv Chatzeres. Amar Rabbi Yosef, mino amin olam, that Rabbi Elazar ben Tadoi is following the Shita, which is Shita's Rabbi Meir, that ein soimchin al shituv b'makom eruv. That's the words here. Oh, ein soimchin al shituv b'makom eruv. They are mamish the same. How do I know that? Because Rav Yehuda Manav says, Allah ki Rav Meir. As we'll learn in a moment, Rav Meir explicitly is the one that says that Ein Soimchen Al Shituv B'makom Eruv. And Rav Bruno, in the name of the same Rav again, said, Allah ki Rav Meir. Now here's the question. The question is, we have a klal, by Eruvin we're lenient. Right? By Avelus and by Eruvin we're lenient. Why did Rav Paskin L'chumra? That's the Maitama. We don't to follow a Das Yachid when the Das Yachid is Machmer. Ah, it must mean it's Nishozaya Das Yachid. It's Rav Meir, it's Rav Elazar ben Tadoi. This gives more justification for Rav to Paskin like him. My Tama Lab Mishum Chataimu. So he's not Paskining like a Yachid Nachluchum. Ooh, says Abaya, that doesn't answer it fully. If that's the case, V'ichatama, Rav only needed to Paskin Halachik Rav Meir. That would have been enough. Now, if you were to ask Rav, why are you paskening like Rav Meir? Then Rav would have explained it to you. It's not only Rav Meir, it's Rav Elazar ben Tadoi. But why did Rav have to announce in public both Halachik Rav Meir and Halachik Rav Elazar ben Tadoi? Why would you need to do that? Rav Meir and Rav Lazar ben Tadoy, you're saying it's the same thing. Now listen to the answer of the Gemara. This is brilliant. We're learning a new klal. Ha kamash v'lan answers the Gemara. That Rav Yosef is right. We're learning the correct shot in this braisa. We're not speaking about whether the shituf mavois works at all. We're not addressing that. We're addressing whether the shituf will also work in the place of an eruv chatzei rois. However, there's another rule, the loy of dinan kitrei chumra be'eruvin. Aside of, we don't paskan like a das yachid. Side of by eruvin, we're lenient. One thing we can never break. If there is one tana whose shita is a double chumra, we'll never paskan like that tana. We can sometimes make an exception and paskan in a machloikas by eruvin, like one tana, if there's only one stringency over the other tana. But if one tana has a double stringency, we can't paskan like it. How does that, what does that have to do with this? Oh, this is so good. Let's read inside Rashi, two lines under the Gemara. Beautifully explaining it out, and that's going to lead us, and I hope we have time to go bite it in the Gemara. So let's go. The Rav Meir is saying two chumras. If Rav would have said, I paskan like Rav Meir, then we would have said, that, how can you do that, Rav? What are the two chumras of Rav Meir? When Rav Meir says, ein shemchen, he means, you can't rely b'chatzeros al shituf mavoi, bein sheneshtatfu b'pas, bein sheneshtatfu b'yayin. Let's go to another detail. Like we keep on mentioning, eruv chatzeros has to be done b'pas. So you would argue that when you say, ein soimchen al shituf b'makom eruv, you know what that would mean? If you used wine for the shituf mavois, then Rav Meir says a chumra, you cannot use that also to allow B'nai Chatzar 1 to enter Chatzar 2. But what were to happen if the Shituf, not the Eruv, if the Shituf was done with Pas? Rav Meir says a double Chumra. Even the Pas, it doesn't work. You never rely on the Shituf B'makim Eruv. That's called a double Chumra, because really it's a two-way Machloikas Tanoim. Let's read inside the Rashi. Upligir Abanan Aleha B'pas. In one braisa, as we'll have in a few lines, the chachamim agree that b'yayin it doesn't work. The pas it works. The rabbanim say that if the shituf was done the pas, then yes, it works b'makim eruv. However, However, the rabbanim of our mishnah, as we just explained, the ha'okim that afilu neshtafu b'yayin, that's the whole yayin. Even b'yayin, right? If you're learning that Rabbi Lazar ben Tadoi is speaking also about whether it works b'makim eruv, that means that our Mishnah also will also be including that. That not only does the shituf work, that also is meduyak in the words of our Mishnah. That einam tzrichim la'arev. Why didn't the Mishnah say einam tzrichim la'shatev? Because the Mishnah is telling you, not only do they not have to make a shituf, they don't even have to make an eruv chatzeres between the two ajein and chatzeres. And our Mishnah is speaking about yayin. So we have the Rabbanan argue with Rav Meir in both. And we can speak out the rest of the Rashi by heart. So Rav couldn't have said that I paskin like Rav Meir, because then he would have been paskining double chumra. Not only do we paskin like Rav Meir, that if they did it, b'yayin it doesn't work, but even the pasa doesn't work. So how does Rav circumvent that? Very simple. Rav says, Alokhi Rav Lazar ben Tadoi. Rav Lazar ben Tadoi was speaking about yayin. So first, Rav already established that if wine is used for the shituf mavois, it doesn't cover an eruv chatzeres. One chumra. Now that that's established, now Rav can say, I pass in like Rav Meir. Because now there's only one argument left, and that is, will pass used for shituf, I'm sorry, let me go on the opposite. First he paskins that if wine is used, very good. If wine is used for the shituf, it doesn't work. It does not work for the eruv chatzeres. Like we said, that's step number one. Now that we established that, now there's a new question. What happens if bread was used for the shituf? So now it's only, we already settled. It's done, the yayin. Now we only focus on the pas. So it's only one chumra. Now Rav goes and says, I paskin like Rabbi Meir.
Rabbi.
Yes.
According to all this that we're saying, at this explanation does this have anything to do with our discussion about partnerships just in a mavoi, or is this only about cases where he's trying to use the shituf?
Both. In other words, just like we began the sugya that the Mishnah has a double chiddush. Number one, a prior partnership works for shituf mavois. Number two, even if it's not all the same people, Reuven and Shimon, Reuven and Levi. Now we're learning a third chiddush, and that is that if the prior partnerships, Reuven and Shimon and Reuven and Levi, yayin be'yayin, if it works for a shituv, not only does it work for a shituv, it also works for a chatzer. And on that
So the Tanakhama of our Mishnah and Reb Shimon of our Mishnah, according to what we're saying right now, hold that when you make a shittub mavoyz, it also is effective to take care of Erev Chatzeres.
Exactly, but let me add one detail.
And even with wine.
Exactly, but one detail. That we're not speaking about your normal Erev Chatzeres according to Rashi. We're speaking about an Erev Chatzeres between two Chatzeres that also have entrances to the Mavoy. This is the Machlekes. Very good. So he made it two steps. First he passed in like a Rosa Ben Tadoi. Then he says, you know what? Now wine doesn't work. It makes sense because wine can never be used for an Erev Chatzeres lechatchila. The Erev Chatzeres, you got to make bread. Then he says, now that I established that the wine doesn't work, even if bread is made, I pass like Rav Meir. That's why he made two statements. Now, guys, I know it's late, but we got to go back to because to start in the middle of this will be very difficult. Says the Gemara, might have made, might have bun on the Tanya. Gavalik, it's simple. Ma'arvin b'chatzeres b'pas. However, ve'im rotzu la'arif b'yayin, that's the klal. You never make an eid of chatzeres. No type of eid of chatzeres b'yayin ma'arvin. Number two, ma'arvin b'mavoy even b'yayin, and ve'im rotzu l'shtatav b'pas, m'shtatav. Bread is good for both. Wine is only good for a mavoy. Now, says the b'raisa, ma'arvin b'chatzeres, if you make an eid of chatzeres, using bread, in the case that we're talking about, every B'nai Chatzar, all of the adjacent B'nai Chatzar already joined in bread. So you will argue, why do you have to make a sheet of Mavoyz? Nevertheless, you make a sheet of Mavoyz, don't allow one to cover the other. They're going to say there was no Eruv. That is Shitas Radme. In other words, whenever a sheet of Mavoyz was done, even if it's done with bread, you still have to make a separate Eruv Chatzeres. Shloi l'shtakach. Chachamim say, I disagree with you, that in the case that we are describing, that you have many Chatzeres going into a Mavui, but these Chatzeres also have an entrance one to the other, either only make Eruv, or only make a Shituv. One or the other. One covers the other. Now there's a nuance, Machlekes Amoraim, that we have to read. It's simple. How to understand their Machlekes. So now on this braisa, there's a machlekes between Rav Nechume, or the Bach says Rav Rechume, and Rabo. One says like this, if pas was used, by the way, the Gemara that we learned above doesn't follow the shita. Right? We just said clearly that Rav Meir argues even the pas, that's the next shita. But one of these Amoraim say that if they're using bread, then either bein lechacham and bein le Rav Meir, whether you use it for the shituv only or for the eruv only, it will work for the other. The machlokes is only be yayin, like we explained. The rationale is yayin can never be used for eruv. That's why Rav Meir says, according to this version, if yayin was used for the shituv, it doesn't cover the eruv. However, daf ayin beis, achadama, no, the opposite. If wine is used, then the kulamul impliga to be an antarte. Kulamul means in this braisa. Don't forget, Danny, that in our Mishnah, the Chachamim hold that wine not only is good for the Shituv, it also is good for the Eruv. That's why beautifully the Mishnah uses the words Tzrichim La'arev, not Tzrichim La'shatev or not. However, ki pligi only b'pas. Oh, and here Rav Meir is Machmer. So that's two versions, and now we're going to try to refute the second version. It says in a braisa, Chachamim Oimrim, this braisa, Oy ma'arvin, oy mishtatvin, my love, oy ma'arvin b'chatzir b'pas, oy mishtatvin b'mavid b'yayin. So we do have a sheet that holds that even if yayin was used, you don't need two. Not like it says in the top line in the Amid. So Rav Gidolomarov says no. Hachi kamar, oy ma'arvin b'chatzir b'pas. And then if you use rez mutarim kan v'kan, then you can use the chatzeros, you can use the mavoy, oy mishtarav b'pas umutarim kan v'kan. But again, when it comes to wine, everyone will agree in this braisa that wine for a shituv does not cover the eruv. What's the halacha? Amar Rav Yehuda. Guys, we have this a few times already. Either we paskin like Rav Meir, halachik Rav Meir, or the minig is like Rav Meir. Rabbi Yechanan says, and you have Rashi 6 lines from the top of the Amud that repeats what we already learned above. Halacha means you darshan so in public, in our context. Minog means you don't give a general rule. If someone asks you on a individual case, you say like Rav Meir. Rav Meir is the Chomer Dikashita. And then the third version is that if someone already followed the din of Rav Meir and they did not rely on the Shitu for the Eruv, after the fact you say, you know what you did is good. You have whom to rely on, which is the Shitu of Rav Meir. God willing, to be continued. Let's go down.
I don't even understand that Nago Rabbi.
Huh?
I mean, of course, if you're more machmir, it's okay. Why is that a chiddush?
I'll tell you why. Because by Eruvin, normally we dafka want to be lenient. It's mamish like in Avelus. That's something that me mamish.
You're saying that if you went strict, it's okay.
Someone does a chumen in Avelus today, I'll give details another time. A rab will tell him you're doing too much. Don't do that.
Rabbi, just quickly on the mavui that they're being mishtatef on. You need a kair and a lachi, right? That's a whole set.
That's a whole separate topic. Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Thank you.
Thank you, Rabbi.
Yeah, that was great.